Each newly coded figure displaying genes can be quickly endowed with gene tags by adding one command. Thus, MATLAB provides the opportunity for user-friendliness and swift coding at the same time. As already discussed, implementation time for many statistical algorithms can be saved by interfacing to or much like a user prefers certain methods, a programmer will save considerable time in programming environments she or he is used to. This applies not only to MATLAB and R personally. I am used to coding tasks requiring regular expressions in Perl, simply because in former times this was not possible in MATLAB. While nowadays comfortable handling of regular expressions is available both in MATLAB and R, I still prefer to use Perl for regular expressions. As discussed below, 4.3, other tasks are best implemented on database level, by using SQL. Thus, interfacing to other languages not only provides the opportunity to plug already implemented code. It also eases new implementations by meeting programmers' preferences as well as by providing the ideal environment for each particular task. As one would expect, using MATLAB, R, C, Perl, Java, and SQL within one system also causes problems. Sloppy programming of interfaces, for example accessing memory not properly allocated, may result in fatal errors, segmentation faults. Object-oriented programming may increase safety and avoid bugs within one language. Nowadays, this is possible for all of the above languages except SQL. But how to send objects and events back and forth through an interface? For M-chips, it proved a successful strategy to keep any interface as simple as possible. The database interface transports only a limited number of data types, resulting in short MEX files. Typecasting can be done within either MATLAB or SQL. Also, the heterogeneity of factors and levels associated to different fields of research, as discussed in the next lecture, is handled already at database level instead of implementing a large and error-prone middleware. Data are transported to and from Perl simply via Unix pipe. Wherever possible, already implemented and tested interfaces were used, such as Perl DBI, http://by.perl.org, for accessing the database from Perl. This module is also independent of the database management system, DBMS, used. Using query syntax common to all SQL dialects, in particular refraining from object relational extensions which tend to be DBMS specific, allows to switch for example from PostgreSQL to Oracle without breaking code. Thus, either using well-established or simple and clear-cut own implementations, problems caused by interfaces are minimal. However, for seamless interaction of the components, such a heterogeneous system requires many modules, libraries, and packages. Installation represents a considerable workload in and of itself, interfering with distributing the system. With the advent of server virtualization, however, all components can be distributed as a whole. Such a virtual machine can be regarded a computer within a computer. It comprises the system including all necessary modules, libraries, and packages plus the operation system in a tested configuration. Further, it will run, with few exceptions, on any hardware and, thanks to extensive standardization, on, almost, any host operation system. Differences related to different technical platforms used for data acquisition, such as microarrays or mass spectrometry, as well as user preferences of different machine learning methods result in the need to add and maintain a large set of algorithms, a task best coped with by interfacing to R and other languages. However, in addition to using different platforms to acquire their data, users will work on different types of samples stemming from highly diverse biological contexts. In the following, I will put forward the thesis that computer-aided interpretation of data from different fields of research with one and the same software package is best coped with by interfacing to a database. As already mentioned, 4.2, analysis of data stemming from new research is necessarily exploratory. In many cases, few hypotheses exist. Thus, the first task of data analysis is to generate hypotheses that can stand verification by subsequent statistical tests. To this end, M-chips provides an unsupervised method that is most exploratory and easy to parametrize as a common view. Correspondence analysis, Fellenberg, 2001, is regularly used by most M-chips users. Belonging to the subclass of planar projection, also called ordination, methods, it shows how discrete, or fuzzy, cluster borders are. Much like principal components analysis, objects will be neighbors in the projection plot, whose quantified signals behave similar. However, unlike principal component analysis, it is able to visualize more than one kind of objects at the same time, also displaying the correspondence, interrelation, between objects of different kind. At this stage, only two kinds of objects exist, genes and measurements. A typical data matrix comprises three or more repeatedly performed measurements, S columns, for each biological condition, with two to at most a few hundred conditions. In stark contrast, the numbers of genes typically range from minimum hundreds to mostly several ten thousands, also resulting in large numbers of genes within each observed cluster. In order to interpret the data, it is necessary to characterize such a gene cluster in terms of one or more descriptive traits. Because a list of hundreds of genes along with their names and traits is too large for visual inspection, extracting descriptive traits has better be done by automatic means. A trait is the more descriptive for a chosen cluster, the more common it is to all, or at least a large share of, cluster members, and the fewer its occurrences outside the cluster, hence to discriminate the cluster from other clusters. Apart from simply comparing the overall frequency of each trait to its frequency in a particular user-selected cluster, Fellenberg, 2003, the traits can for example also be visualized by correspondence analysis. To this end, characteristic traits are filtered, from the vast majority of uninformative ones, and displayed as centroids in the middle of the cluster of genes they apply to, Bussold, 2005. For any statistics simple or sophisticated, the instances of occurrence for any given trait must be countable by a computer. For genes, among other sources, the Gene Ontology, Go, initiative, http://geneontology.org, provides a controlled vocabulary of terms annotating gene products in a computer-readable format. The terms are subcategorized from general to special traits by IS-A and part of relations that form the edges of a directed acyclic graph. The same set of terms, ordered by the same graph, is applicable to the genes of every organism under study, a priceless bonus for data integration. The value of any trait set universally applicable to all fields of research can be best appreciated by regarding traits for which this is not the case. While any gene either shows phospholipid translocating ATPase activity, Go:0004012, or not, growth conditions may be characterized by temperature, additive concentrations, and other variables of continuous range. Also, a biological sample can be processed by a wide variety of different wet lab protocols prior to data acquisition and preprocessing. Each step may influence the observed patterns by contributing specific systematic errors. Thus, representing these steps within the sample annotations can serve to track down artifacts. Even more complex than the description of wet lab protocols, but also more interesting, is the description of the samples. Their composition ranges from only one cell type and heterogeneous mixtures to complete organs and organisms. Organisms, genotypes, phenotypes, disease stages, clinical data, or culture conditions may need to be accounted for. Biological contexts under study by means of high-throughput quantification are highly diverse. Traits annotating culture conditions for yeast are not applicable to plants growing in a greenhouse. Soil type and circadian light rhythms are irrelevant to cancer research. There are initiatives to describe all fields of research into one ontology, Mage OM, Brasma, 2003. However, the complexity of the controlled vocabulary is overwhelming. Most terms are not applicable to a particular field of research, while terms important to describe novel aspects of a new biological context are often missing. Often it is not known a priori if a particular trait is relevant for the biological context under study or not. Omitting it bears the risk of overlooking something important. As for the genes, lists of hundreds of samples along with their specific traits are too large for visual inspection. Thus, the global players driving the observed expression patterns of the samples need to be extracted from a large number of irrelevant traits computationally. MChips organizes these traits in a database tailored for computational analysis, Data Warehouse, Fellenberg, 2002. The database structure is flexible enough to provide for each field of research a tailor-made arbitrarily structured trait set comprising both enumeration type variables and those of continuous range. It also accounts for rapid growths of each trait set with new kinds of experiments. These very different trait sets, currently 13, http://mchips.